Welcome to Love Powered, the space where we engage in thought-provoking, soul-evoking, and heart-opening conversations about life and its initiations. My name is Tatiana. I'm a HeartMath certified mentor and transformation guide, helping people to remember the innate intelligence of their hearts so they may intentionally create a joyful and fulfilling life. I'm also a human, living in this world of polarity, in this transformational time for humanity. I believe the future belongs to happy people. The world where love, unity, and peace are our main values is the world we are all creating right now. It is my intent with this heart-opening content to inform you of what's truly possible for you, uplift your spirits, and to inspire you to live your life love-powered. Over the next few episodes, I'll invite some of the people that I find truly inspiring, that I know live their life from a heart-centered space. People who have had their share of challenges, of initiations, and who have, throughout all of it, remembered the wisdom of their heart, remembered the true essence of our life and of our life force is love. But for now, I'd like to introduce myself, to share with you my life story, where I came from, where I am now, and where I'm going. I have prepared some questions to help guide this conversation that I'm about to have with myself. And I believe that life is a conversation between us and life, divine, God, whatever you call that innate intelligence, that life force that flows through all of us. Love-powered living. That is where I am at right now. That is the reoccurring theme and the ongoing contemplations that I have with myself at all times. How can I love more? How can I live my life from a place of love? Using my heart as a beacon of light to guide my decisions, to guide my actions, to guide my intentions. How can I bring more love into my life? With everything going on in the world, it may seem like we are collapsing. It may seem like we are being challenged. It may seem like chaos and turmoil. And yes, it is. And yet, how can we love more through all of it and all of it truly? Because life is versatile and multi-dimensional experience. There is such a spectrum of emotions that we get to feel in a given day, honestly. There is such a spectrum of experiences that we are given. Some may seem like challenges. Some are opportunities in disguise for us to step up, to step fully into what it means to be human, what it means to be a fully aware human who is capable and is resilient and is able enough to be the creator of our life and to choose love through all of it. This is so much fun. I am originally from Ukraine. I've moved to States in 2006. I was studying English as a second language, I studied English to be a teacher, ESL, English as a second language teacher in Ukraine. Most of us had an opportunity to travel abroad for student exchange programs. I came as an au pair. It's a student exchange / nanny program where I was fortunate enough to be with the family that is very mature. They are beautiful people and they welcomed me. They took care of me as one of their own. Unfortunately, some of my friends had quite the opposite experience. And maybe eventually I'll get into this conversation about au pair experience, because there is so much to it, truly. But I was fortunate enough to have a great, great experience as an au pair. After that program finished, I extended my stay. I decided to stay in the States. And I went to school to study psychology. The way life unfolded, here I am, still in the States, 18 years later. That is a wild number for me to consider, because in 2 years, that will be just as long as I have spent living in Ukraine. Yeah, that's quite a reality check in a way. I moved here when I was 20 years old, a young adult, more like a child, honestly. Was I mature enough for that experience? No. Did I mature through that experience? Absolutely. 2010, my father passed away. It was really hard on me. I wasn't equipped with tools that I have now. I wasn't mature enough. I didn't have the support system that I have now. Both my mother and my sister were going through their own grief process in their own way. But I think grief in general is a very personal experience. And as important it is to surround yourself with a community who can support you through that portal of grief, it is still your own journey. My journey led me to fully immersing myself into work. At the time, I worked in this swanky hip restaurant / lounge in downtown DC, a hot spot. The work was very intensive for me to not have to think about anything else. So I immersed myself into work. Being young and 23, I also immersed myself into avoiding my feelings and having fun instead of grieving. I partied a lot, drinking, going to parties, dancing up until early mornings, waking up at noon and doing it all over again. I was avoiding my pain. I was avoiding grieving. And eventually, a few years later, I found myself depressed. I had really bad anxiety. I was sick. I had adrenal fatigue, which comes with the type of job working in a hospitality industry. It's high stress, high intensity, long nights on your feet. There is not much of a taking care of your body either, because you end up eating French fries at midnight on the go. You end up having a terrible sleep schedule that eventually led me to where I ended up, without dealing with my grief, processing the death of my father, plus the environment that I put myself into, all manifested for me in this deep, deep depression, terrible anxiety, chest pains, shortness of breath. I was sick. And on the paper, you could say that I was thriving. I had lavish trips. I had lots of friends surrounding me. I was living my life. Inside, I was slowly dying. Eventually, I sought help. And of course, I went to a doctor who asked me what happened. Did not address if I was taking care of my emotional health, if I was talking to someone, how I was addressing the trauma that I experienced. And just prescribed me medication, strongest one on the market, antidepressants, and diagnosed me with a post-traumatic anxiety disorder. Naturally, as somebody who has been very inquisitive and very intuitive whole life, I started seeking other methods. I began meditating. I began doing EFT and tapping, eventually led me to do a lot of breath work, which started moving grieving process, that trauma release through my body. Absolutely fascinated by the effect these modalities had on my body, mind, and soul, I started learning more. At the time, I was studying psychology, immersed myself into studying ancient texts, always being very existential. I was diving deep into death and life and what it truly means to be here. Why are we here? When you have that kind of life-changing experience, like losing a loved one or a health condition, a health scare, or anything else traumatic that shakes up you to the core, you begin to question things. You begin to question your life. You begin to question life in general. And my exploration eventually led me to a lot of different therapeutic modalities, energy work. I was being guided by a lot of absolutely powerful, beautiful mentors and guides. I studied theta healing, Atma healing. I immersed myself in the science of transformation, eventually led me to Dr. Joe Dispenza's work, which I'm forever grateful for all of my teachers. I would not be where I am right now if I did not have that support of somebody who has walked that path. Eventually, I not only healed my broken heart, but I transformed my life. How can I continue holding my pure essence of my heart through all of my life experiences that can be so challenging, that can be so heartbreaking? How can I continue being human? Who knows that love is our true essence? Love is what we are made of or from, and love is who we are here to be and experience. Eventually ended up on this path of being a guide and a mentor. Before that, I also had other careers, like a hospitality professional working in a restaurant for a very long time. Then I had my own business of a cotton candy cart with my business partner, where we served weddings, mitzvahs, other fancy events with our gourmet cotton candy. Then my journey of healing my eating disorder that I kind of gained through all of my life, but manifested greatly. I was working through this process of grieving. I created and started a raw vegan dessert business that I closed last year to fully align who I am with what I do. Because up until that point, who I was this person deeply committed to personal growth, deeply committed to helping people, to serving people. But I was serving people in a way that wasn't aligned with who I was. My true service is in the service of the heart. My own heart, heart of humanity, heart of the people I love and the people I get to guide now. And I made a conscious decision to align all of me in what I do, to walk this path of being a guide and a mentor. And it is an unfolding path, a blossoming. And every day I get to experience supporting somebody in their own process, finding their unique essence, unique voice, unique expression in the life, finding their joy again, going through loss of a loved one like I did, get to walk with them the path that I once walked. It is a very humbling experience for me to witness it now from a greater level of understanding. So when war in Ukraine began, experienced some of that trauma again. My family is still in Ukraine and was in Ukraine when war began, was activated. My trauma, the ancestral trauma, got reactivated. I never imagined that something like that would ever happen. But now I see how that experience prepared me for what is unfolding in the world right now and what is about to unfold. And that experience gave me greater clarity about what it truly means for me to be alive and to be of service. How can I fully live my life? And how can I continue living from my heart, in accordance with my values, showing up for the world, for myself, for my family, for my people, hold that duality of war and peace? How can I bring more of that peace into myself and cultivate more of it? Because I believe that individually and then, of course, collectively, we are the ones creating the world we live in. That's why it's so important for me right now to share this message and to engage in these conversations to remind people of what is truly important and to remind people that even though it seems the world is burning, it is burning. It is the birthing of a new world and we are changing paradigms. We are living in living on a cusp of what was and what will be. We get to create that world. And it begins with each one of us. It begins with acquiring, becoming aware, and then eventually taking responsibility and creating that world that we want to live in. For me, that world is peace in each one of us, in our countries, in our communities, in our world. For me, that's love, a kind, compassionate, open-hearted people who collaborate, who cooperate, who create and co-create this world. This is not the time to play around. This is the time to go all in and to intentionally align ourselves with what we are creating and show up for ourselves, for our lives, for our children, and for humanity. And for some of us, that may seem just like showing up for your kids every day and being the best parent you can. And for some of us, that's taking on a greater role. I'm still afraid to speak up and to share what is truly important to me, to have voice, to give voice to my voice. And this space is a form of my expression to share with others what I know to be true, what I know so many of us know to be true. But still, there is old programs, old beliefs, and some of it is generational, some of it is ancestral, some of it is maybe even other lives. There is so much uncovered there. The story to share is, I don't know if you can see, but this little girl here, that's here in 1990. I was with my sister and my mom at this photo salon taking pictures to send to my father, who was in Iraq at the time on a prolonged business trip. Photographer told me to stop smiling so much. I'm gonna pull up another picture because that's me smiling. But it wasn't allowed to smile in Ukraine, in Soviet Union, and in a lot of other cultures too, especially socialist countries. And then because things like, well, you can't let other people know that you are happy. You cannot show your joy and your love for life so openly and so freely because you might be killed for it. Quite literally, as my ancestors experienced that with the Communist and Socialist Party coming, how many of people lost all of their possessions, all of their states and lives as well through that period. And then Inquisition, how many of us were burned for being ourselves, for speaking that truth? And then, of course, there are, you know, childhood experiences and school experiences where you are put in a box, where you can only be a certain way and you can't let your joyful, fun expression show up. And so for me, it's kind of a better experience for me to share so openly, to get engaged in these conversations and show up for myself, for this little self, and for this one, and for all of those who might be also feeling the same way. We all have very different experiences, but we are all experiencing the same thing. And all of those turbulations, opportunities for us to grow into fully relaxed, fully safe beings who are free to express themselves. So that's a personal reason why it's so important for me to show up in this way and to create this space to go also give voice to others. I know so many people who have these amazing stories, life stories, stories of transformation, stories of overcoming huge obstacles in their lives and still showing up, living from this heart-centered space, choosing love. Oh, they may call it something else, but for me, that means choosing love, to show up and be your best self, regardless of what circumstances, limitations you have in your life, to be greater than any of those old, outdated programs that we've all been conditioned into and indoctrinated into. How would I like to be remembered? This is an interesting one because death is a big part of our life. Maybe because of my initiation into life from experiencing the death of my father, I ponder this question quite often. And the other day, I was driving and it was twice in a day, this car would like swerve right next to me, barely avoiding an accident, I guess. When it happened second time in a day, I was like, whoa, life could go on. I would not be here. So how do I want to actually live my life? Do I want to give in to fears and limitations? Do I want to show up no matter how scary it is? Do I want to keep hiding from the world? I want to keep hiding my weirdness, my joy, my freedom, my love, because it's safer that way. Do I want to show up, be weird, and have these existential conversations and go through the process of becoming more and more aware, which is all of it is leading us to realize our wholeness? And it made me very sad that the world would go on and I would not be in it. So I want to be remembered. I want to be remembered as a person who inspired others. Inspired them not by smart words, not even by big achievements or actions, but inspired them by being herself. But inspires others to be themselves, whatever that means for them, to be the best versions of themselves, to ask the hard questions, to contemplate these existential big topics, and to live fully. Dr. Joe says, joy is expression without limitation. And I believe, as women at least, that is why we're here. To express our joy, the pleasure of being alive, the depth of our heart, the width of our awareness, of our multidimensionality, of what it truly means to be human in this body, in this world that is always changing as we are changing, and what it truly means to hold on that essence of our heart. For me, the essence of my heart is joy. For me, it's love. For me, it's informing and inspiring others to find it for themselves, to experience joy of being alive, to experience the ease and the comfort in our own bodies, comfort of being safe in our own body, in our environment, to experience the expansion of reaching further and deeper or higher than what we've been led to know or believe in our lifetime. How can I be more alive in me? How can I serve my people better? Because by serving one, we're serving all. How can I serve myself better? No short orders here. This moment, because it will never happen again. Stay fully aware and fully present with everything that is unfolding and that is blossoming. There is so much wisdom, so much medicine in being present with all of us in any given moment, but especially in the moment of unfolding of your life. And your life is always unfolding. Enjoy it. Enjoy every single part of it. And there was a bee in my window. And on this note, we will finish. If you are still here watching until this moment, thank you so much for letting me have this conversation. There's still parts of me like, what the? Talking to yourself in the camera? But I'm so grateful for you for tuning in, engaging with this conversation. I would love to know what resonated with you as you heard me speak. What questions are you asking of your life right now? How would you like to be remembered? What's important to you? What is the world you are creating? Or anything else that resonated, that didn't resonate, that stood out to you in this conversation? I would love to hear from you. Thank you so much for being here on this journey with me and with yourself. And I leave you with one more note. How can you love your life more? There is so much to love in this life, in our life. So much great things are happening. Ordinary people doing extraordinary things. Gods being awakened. Our world is changing. The paradigm is shifting. And you get to experience it firsthand. Thank you for being here. See you in the next episode.